Hello and welcome. My name is Jack Hirsch of the Daily Collegian Football Staff, along with Andrew Rubin of the Daily Collegian Football Staff, and today is National Signing Day. But, Andrew, we didn't really see too many movement in the Nittany Lions class. 23 signees. What changed today?
Well, I mean, the only addition for Penn State was Rasheed Walker, four-star offensive tackle, one of the best offensive tackles in the nation. And with that, now, Penn State has two of the better offensive tackles in this class, with Nana Asiedu already signed in December. As far as, like, not a lot of movement, I mean, that was expected. Penn State signed, really, 22 guys in December in the new early sign period. Of course, this was the first class of the new early sign period. And Jason Owe, it was really 21 in December, but he didn't announce until January, even though he was already signed. So we weren't expecting a lot of movement. Up until this week, it was looking like Penn State was going to get a wide receiver at Arizona, Solomon Ennis. His dad played here, was Curtis Ennis. And then possibly a wide receiver from Harrisburg, Shaquan Anderson Butts. But he ended up going the community college route, which was somewhat expected after he was the only verbal commit not to sign in December.
Yeah, 23 signees. Obviously, probably the two that they were hoping for was Ennis and Shaquan Anderson Butts. Those didn't happen. What also didn't happen was James Franklin's press conference. Did not officially happen. You were on the conference call that ended up taking place. What kind of feel did you get from that?
Well, I mean, it's just a quick call. I mean, it was supposed to be a press conference at Beaver Stadium, and it got canceled because of snow, so it was a conference call. And the main thing was they introduced the two new assistants, Juwan Sider from Florida, who comes over as a running back coach, and David Corley, who comes over as the wide receivers coach from Army. And my biggest thing with that was Franklin made it clear they're going to make a shift in recruiting with the hire of Sider. He's from South Florida. He's a star at Glade Central, which is a big program in Palm Beach County. He coached high school football down there for a long time in the West Palm Beach area. They're going to focus more heavily on recruiting the South with Sider. He's got connections down there. And Franklin even said he gets us into conversations indoors we probably wouldn't have gotten into in those regions before. And I think that's going to be important in 2019 because Pennsylvania's class just isn't that deep, and it isn't as deep as it normally is.
Yeah, so a lot to think about moving forward to 2019 recruiting now, but let's take it. What's next for Penn State?
I mean, next for Penn State's obviously spring football and developing the current team. They got a lot to build on after last year, but they're losing a lot, so guys are going to be stepping into bigger roles. But the biggest thing is from today is you signed an elite class. You got a top five class, and there's not many schools that had a significant upgrade in town over you. And really, the only ones you could say are clear cut better right now would be Georgia and Ohio State. And other than that, you're going to be right in the mix with everybody else and starting from a better basis point than everybody else as you move forward.
Yeah, Penn State ending the day as the number four class in a lot of the major rankings. That'll do it for us, for Jack Hirsch and Andrew Rubin. We'll take you from the next Penn State football event, and we'll see you then.
Thank you.